We want to determine the equation of the line passing through the two given points. We want the linear equation to be in both point-slope form and slope-intercept form. Notice both of these equations do require the slope, and since we're given two points on the line, we can use the formula m equals y2 minus y1 divided by x2 minus x1. So if we call these the ones and these the twos, this would be x1, y1, x2, y2. So using our slope formula, we would have -1. Now using the slope formula, y2 minus y1 would be -1 minus 1 all over x2 minus x1. That would be 5 minus 1. So we have -2 all over 4, which simplifies to -1/2. And now we have everything we need to write the point-slope form of a line. Remember, x1, y1 is any point on the line, so we actually have a choice. We can use this first point or the second point to write the point-slope form of a line. If we use this first point, where both coordinates are +1, we would have the equation y minus y1, which is 1, equals the slope, -1/2, times x minus x1. x1 is also 1. So this would be the equation in point-slope form using the first point. But we could also use this point here that's on the line. So let's go ahead and do that. Now notice that the y-coordinate is -1, so in this form, we would have y minus -1, which would be y plus 1, equals m, -1/2, times the quantity x minus x1, which is +5, so we have x minus 5. And both of these are correct, so it is important to recognize that an equation in point-slope form is not unique. And then for the second part, we want to write the linear equation in slope-intercept form. And since we already have point-slope form, we can take either of these equations and solve for y. Let's go ahead and use this first one. So if we have y minus 1 equals -1/2 times the quantity x minus 1, we'll start by distributing here. So we'd have y minus 1 equals, this would be -1/2 x, and this becomes +1/2. And then we add 1 to both sides to solve for y. This would be 0, so now we have y equals, this would be -1/2 x, and then 1/2 plus 1 would be 1/2. But most of the time you won't see this as a mixed number. Let's go ahead and write this as an improper fraction. We would have y equals -1/2 x, and this would be +3/2. So once we have the equation in point-slope form, it's a pretty straightforward process to determine the slope-intercept form of the linear equation. We just have to solve it for y.